What's up, y'all? This is Minister Williams. I am here today because I really want to share a message with you guys that me and my children encountered this morning. And it was so refreshing to me that I felt the unction in my spirit to share it with you guys. And I'm going to title it, "Cause My Daddy's the Pilot and He's Taking Me Home." And this story is about a pastor. And he's traveling and he's going from flight to flight. You know, he's getting on an airplane, and he gets on the airplane and the first warning approaches him that a problem is about to take suit. And how he knows is because there's a sign on the airplane that says, "Fasten your seatbelts." So once that comes up, he initially knows that there's a problem. And you can only imagine how he feels when he's been going from plane to plane, traveling, and then to get on another plane, and then the sign of warning comes that something, you know, is not right. And it says again, "Fasten your seatbelts." And then after a while, a calm voice said, "We shall not be serving the beverages at this time, as we are expecting a little turbulence. Please be sure your seatbelt is fastened." So they were warning them, letting them know, you know, that's another sign, you know, this is not looking good. And so all the passengers on there, the pastor gets to looking around and everybody is panicking. They're worried, you know, they're not going to make it out, you know, and all these things. So as he's looking around at them, you know, and everybody else is worried, he's getting worried too, you know, because, you know, everybody else around him is worried. But he happens to see this little girl. And she's sitting by herself. She's in her seat. And she folds her, you know, feet. I can only imagine Indian style in the seat. And she's reading a book. So while all the adults are on the plane being worried, you know, saying things out loud as the pastor is looking around and he's seeing it, you know. And as he's taking on fear and worry and anxiety because everybody else is, he sees this little girl and she's just unbothered by everything that's going on around her, and she's reading her book. And so the story goes on to where the plane is in a storm, and the thunder is so loud, you know, it's louder than the engine. It's dark clouds. The plane is shifting left and right, and you know they're in the middle of a storm, because you can only, you know, imagine how bad, you know, it really was. And so they finally made it through the storm. And it begins to calm. And as the plane landed, all the adults ran off the plane because they were so, you know, worked up by what had happened. And the pastor waited. You know, he let all the frantic people pass him by because he wanted to talk to the little girl to see, you know, what kept her so calm on the plane. And a child at that, and all the adults were frantic with worry and anxiety. And he went up to her and he asked her, because he couldn't hardly believe his eyes, and it was surprising when the plane, so after commenting about the stormy behavior of the plane, he asked why she had not been afraid. So the pastor asked her, "Why had you not been afraid?" And the child replied, "Cause my daddy's the pilot and he's taking me home." So I want to use that to encourage you guys that no matter how bad the storm is, no matter what your circumstances look like when everybody else around you is freaking out because everything, it seems to be going down and it seems like it's not getting better and it seems like it's close to the end, we want to be like the little girl. She was anchored because she knew no matter what's going on around me, my daddy is the pilot. He's driving. I know he's going to protect me. I know he's going to shield me. And I know that no matter what, my daddy is going to take me home in Jesus' name. So let that encourage you today, because it encouraged me and it also encouraged my children today, that my daddy is the pilot and he's taking me home. So don't let your circumstances, what's going on around you, work you up. Don't let the people around you that are discouraged in their actions and what they say, don't let it fall on you. Because even the pastor admitted, you know, looking around at these people, these adults, and you know, they're frantic and they're upset and they're worried. It wore off on him. But be like the little girl, be steadfast, be unmovable. study your word, know what the word of God says, because she was meditating on that book, and she knew enough about her father to know that he was the pilot, he was driving, and that he was going to get her home. In Jesus' name, y'all be blessed.